macOS Sequoia is now out for all supported Macs, so I even have it here on my 2020 M1 MacBook Air with no features missing. Apple did a lot of flexing this year about their AI features or Apple Intelligence features, but sadly, none of that is included with 15.0. Intelligence features like writing tools and Image Playground are all coming later on this year. Still, there are still a few really nice changes with this first version of macOS Sequoia, so let me take you through my favorites and show you guys what this is all about. The number one most exciting feature is definitely the new iPhone mirroring feature. You can see your phone screen and use it directly from your Mac, so you can access all your phone apps and finally do things you weren't able to do on macOS. There's keyboard and trackpad support, and even your gestures work right on your iPhone. A touchscreen would be even better, but this still works super smoothly. You even get your phone notifications, and they sync up in real time on macOS. On top of all that, your phone screen can stay turned off, so you're not wasting much battery while doing this. It's kind of hard to believe how long it took for this feature to be a real thing, but I'm really glad it's here because it's a super convenient option for those of you in the Apple ecosystem. This definitely beats Microsoft's current implementation of Phone Link on Windows with Android phones. Another feature that has been a long time coming is window snapping, which is finally on macOS now. You can drag any app or browser window over to an edge or corner and it'll snap into place. You can also use the set keyboard shortcuts to snap windows into places, super easy and convenient for organizing your running apps in Windows. Apple calls it window tiling, but yeah, this has been a super convenient feature on Windows since all the way back to Windows 7. But that doesn't matter anymore, even though I still prefer the third-party options like Rectangle because they offer additional customization for keyboard shortcuts. I'm so glad this is finally a native feature on Mac for more users to actually try out. This will make life a lot easier for people, especially for multitaskers like me. Just like on iOS 18, Apple's native password manager is now its own standalone app on macOS. Instead of being buried in the settings, you can use Spotlight Search or a dock shortcut to open up passwords super easily. Of course, you can use this to access all your saved logins, passwords, and Wi-Fi passwords, but the best part about this is that passwords now supports two-factor authentication right from your Mac. So instead of relying on a third-party authenticator from your phone, you can get two-factor codes straight from your laptop and they'll autofill for you on all the sites you need them for on Safari. All this is synced to iCloud too, so you can easily migrate these across all your Apple devices. Also, just like iOS 18, Sequoia is getting the same treatment for its Messages app. Just to confirm for those of you wondering, you can receive and send RCS messages on the Mac version of the Messages app, so that's great. You'll no longer be left out of high-quality images, reactions, and read receipts from your Android friends. Just like on the phone, there are new text effects where you can customize your text to emphasize what you're trying to say. You can resize certain words, make them explode, bloom, jitter, etc., etc. Also, you can finally schedule messages too, so if you need to remind a family member or friend about something at a certain time, this will definitely come in handy. The Notes app is basically one of the main native apps that Mac users use, and it's also got some low-key upgrades that are low-key very useful. You can now directly record voice memos right from the note, and you can get full transcriptions for them. So with this, you can just take your laptop to classes and meetings and take all the notes you need without having to type much. Plus, there are now these collapsible sections so you can better organize your much longer list of bullet points. If your notes are more math or finance related, Notes gives you automatic calculations based on the expressions and equations you typed out, so you don't really have to open the calculator app to do these simple equations. But adding on to that, the calculator app did see a nice little improvement, which I've been asking for a long time. Not only can the calculator app now solve expressions and convert units, you can now display history, which is so welcome. macOS's calculator app has been a black hole for a long time, so it's great that you can finally see your previous calculations. I will probably now make less calculation mistakes thanks to this. We're still waiting on all those promised Apple Intelligence features, but I'm personally really satisfied we got iPhone mirroring and window tiling. They're not the most exciting features since they're not really bleeding tech, but these were things that users have been asking for a long time. These might not up Apple's stock as much as the AI features, but I think these are the things that really matter. Still, not the biggest update, but some welcome changes nonetheless. Let me know your thoughts on macOS Sequoia and how the experience has been for you so far. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.